Victoria from Alexandria, Virginia, and I'm here today looking at the silkworm project, and I think it's really so innovative and such a great way to show a living art that changes over time, but also keeps us in touch with the natural environment and also involves children. I think this is really one of the most creative things I've seen in the area in a long time.
And I love it. I live in the area. I come here for the art classes, so I'm just passing by. And this caught my eye from the second floor, and just the patches, just the pattern of white, and then this little swirl. And I love silk, so this is something that's very, to me, very sensuous, very flowy, you know, just like oil paint. And then at the same time, the basic act of making it is so rough, in some sense. And just the juxtaposition of the two is very fabulous, so thank you.
Lippitt, and I have 21 kindergartners at Drew Model School in Arlington, Virginia that worked with LCV this year on the silkworm project. Very excited every time they got to go to art, and we got to keep some silkworms in our classroom and watch them spin and watch them
twist. Hi, I'm Kathy Kelkis. I teach primary Montessori, 3 to 6 year olds, and we've been doing the silkworm project for 2 years. The kids had 22 silkworms in the classroom this year, and they loved watching them spin and make their cocoons and develop into beautiful.
You know, I teach primary Montessori, and my children enjoyed watching the silkworms as they were spinning on top of the carts, and they really enjoyed watching them even after they were done spinning and looking to see how they changed either inside or outside.
I'm Maureen Alvey, and I teach 4th and 5th grade mathematics. The kids were really excited to be working with the silkworms. They asked about them all the time. They would always want to visit the classrooms. They love holding them and seeing them grow. And they just really enjoy it.
The delightful process of watching silkworms go through the entire life cycle, from worms who were eating and then spinning, and then watching them spin on their little platforms, which was awesome. Every day we looked in the little container we had them in and watched to see if they were moths yet. And they were finally all moths. Everyone was very thrilled.
My name is Amanda Chu, and I teach a K-1 Montessori class at Drew Model School. The Silkworm Project was amazing to see real life animals connected to art.
My name is Elizabeth Rente. I'm a kindergarten teacher here at Barrett Elementary School, and my kids really enjoyed the Silkworm Project. They loved watching the silkworms form the silk and monitoring them day to day. They enjoyed collecting all the materials that they needed for it, and overall I think the project went really well, and it taught them more and more about the silkworm process.
Hi, I'm Katie Hickman.
And I'm Gabby Wells.
And we teach at Barrett Elementary School. We teach at K-3. When they first came in and the worms were there, they were crazy, and they ran over and they all wanted to touch them and pick them up, but the worms were already working, so we kind of had to try and keep them away. As much as possible. And then they were all fascinated when the worms would fall off and just lay and turn like into their cocoon. And one of our kids was just so into it, and just every day was going over to check on how they were doing. And,
they were very conscious of them tipping over or falling off the little cart.
Well, when they were working and the worms would like put their head up like this, I had one kid that would look over and say, Miss H, the worms come like this every single time. So it was a lot of fun. It was a fun project.
Yeah, I like the silkworm because it's so pretty and very cute. What I like about the silkworm is it's really cute and it has black stripes. Silkworms are very nice and they are squishy and they're soft.
The silkworm survives the process of spinning like this. They make these little shapes for 72 hours, and then they turn into a pupa, and then the pupa turns into a moth, and the moth lays eggs, and the process starts all over again. You feed the worms for 4 weeks.
This little thing over here is a pupa. See, next to it is the skin. He looks like a dead worm. See, this one looks like a dead worm. But he sheds his little skin and then he turns into a pupa. Come, let's see. Now he doesn't bite, he just tickles. Can you hold out your hand? Okay. There we go. think